A dynamic archive is different than a fixed archive. Dynamic archives are used, well, they're generally used for exceptional things, not for day-to-day data collection. And in fact, we don't really cover dynamic archives in any detail in this class. It's more part of our advanced topics system management class. So it's usually something that's created by the Pi server or the Pi utilities themselves that are used for special circumstances. For example, a Pi Arc SS can actually create a dynamic archive when it's doing it's being used as what we call the offline archive in offline mode to reprocess an archive. Now, what a dynamic archive is it's an archive that simply does not establish its full size or its true size at the time at which it's initialized. When it's initialized, we simply create a primary record for each tag in the system that exists at that point. And then as we fill it with data, we simply add new overflow records, not from the back of the archive file, from the end of the file, but we just add new primary or new overflow records to the front of the file. So in fact, the dynamic archive, as its name implies, dynamic means it's going to grow in size as you watch it. Now, we do have a relatively new feature in which if you're trying to write data to a fixed archive that's in the past, not the primary archive, if you're trying to write to the fixed archive for a period of time that has expired, and now let's say this is your third archive in the sequence, we're automatically going to convert that into a dynamic archive if you accidentally fill that archive. Now, as I mentioned, archives have a small amount of free space in them for doing a moderate amount of modifications. But if for some reason you fill that entirely, we'll simply convert that over to a dynamic archive. I want to warn you, though, remember, dynamic archives, unlike fixed archives, they don't participate in the archive shift. So now this is going to result in having one more archive that can't be shifted into. You can create these yourself using this archives plugin in SMT. So you can create this yourself, for example, to receive backfill data from another historian or from a spreadsheet or some other data store that you've got. Every once in a while, people come to us with, you know, these months and months or years worth of data they'd like to backfill into the Pi server. So it's a good idea to use a dynamic archive. You would be using that since you didn't know, you may not know exactly how many values you're going to get, and you want to be as open-ended as possible for that retrieval. So those are dynamic archives. As I said, we're not going to cover them in great detail in this class.